Good morning to you. It's nice looking at that because you kind of see the whole history of your musical life, really. And the Wanted, they were put together in 2009, but I think it was a year later that everything just went crazy, and that was quite quick, really.
It was really quick, yeah. I think I remember when our first song, All Time Low, I think on the Friday we were performing at a school in front of about 20 kids, and then on the Sunday it was at number one.
That's mad, then
it all changed.
And what does that do to you when it happens?
It was a bit of a shock. Yeah, it was a bit of a shock. It was like, on the day when it happened, it was the best feeling ever. The sort of following weeks, I found it a little bit strange because literally there was always people outside your door. Everyone was always taking pictures and stuff wherever you went. And I don't know, it sort of wasn't what I thought it was quite going
to
be.
It led to, I mean, you got very anxious. You had to have therapy.
Yeah, I did actually at one point, yeah. I think it was just, I worked so hard and so long to get there. And then when I got it, I kind of really liked the stuff before, you know, the working up to that bit, doing like the pubs and the clubs and all that. I actually thought, I kind of miss doing that now.
Yeah.
But then I learned to sort of embrace it, and then eventually, I loved every minute of it.
Well, the band did very well, that's for sure, and then you all went your separate ways, and now you are going solo, so sort of performing, because there was a time when it looked like the music had gone completely, sort of gone down the acting route.
Yeah. Well, I moved to America to do acting, and subsequently ended up in Glee. So I did that, and then after that was the plan then, was to keep acting. But I met Jason Derulo in LA, and he said that he thought I should get back into music. And I thought, well, he's not a bad person to say that to me. So I listened to him, and I got in the studio and we started writing songs and stuff, and I thought, do you know what, actually, I do really miss it. So I'm going to focus on that again. And I've been focusing on it for like the last sort of 2.5, 3 years now.
Wow.
And now I feel sort of ready to really start pushing
it. Show
it to the
world.
Yeah.
it's funny, because Jason Derulo, he's been a bit of a mentor to you, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, he has. After The Wanted sort of finished and I was looking at acting, it didn't really occur to me at all to sort of do anything on my own. It was never something I thought about when I was in the band. And obviously the success he's had as a solo artist and stuff, so when he was saying to me that he believed in me, then obviously I had to take that on board, and I did. And I feel pretty comfortable with it now, because I wasn't at first.
But when you look to your side and you haven't got the boys there, that must feel pretty strange.
Yeah, it is a bit. You know, I've had a little bit to get over it,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
Well, I've been texting Meghan.
I haven't. I don't know where that came from.
I love your
from.
I haven't.
I haven't. No, I didn't.
You were saying it to your dad then.
You know, I feel like I am. Where is he? He's here, actually.
Well, he's managing you now.
He is, yeah.
So what was that story? Was there any?
I don't know where that came from. I did read something over the weekend, but I also read that there was something to do with it, looking for an Englishman or whatever. And I don't get why they're doing this to her at the minute, but it certainly wasn't.
Well,
she wasn't looking for me anyway.
There was no communication?
No, there was nothing. There was nothing from my side. There was nothing.
Was there from her side?
No, it wasn't. There's nothing in it.
OK. So you're back here now because you were living in LA for a little while.
Yeah.
And so you're back living in Manchester.
I am.
So what's that like?
It's lovely, yeah.
Nice to be home.
Yeah, I was away for over 5 years, so and to come back, my friends, my family, and everything's great.
Does it feel different? Do you feel like you're sort of more prepared this time than you were, say, 10 years ago with The Wanted, when it all just went crazy?
Yeah, I think so. I feel a lot more settled now.
Yeah.
And obviously, I think you just grow up like naturally anyway.
Yeah.
I do feel.
And you've got
more.
Stacey, haven't you?
I have.
Yeah. It must be nice. You've got someone with you who you can.
Yeah. She's awesome.
Oh, good.
And is it true that there is the possibility of a band reuniting?
Possibly. I've spoken to Tom on many occasions, and he always brings it up. And I'm certainly one for it, not against it. So, I don't know, next year's like, I think next summer will be our 10th anniversary of our first single coming out, so.
That would be a good time to do it.
When you split up, as a band, were you enjoying it?
As a band, I think we enjoyed it more earlier on as a band.
Yeah.
I think individually some of us were enjoying it more than others.
Mm. Because the only reason I asked that was that we've had so many bands on this sofa who've reunited years afterwards, who said, you know, you get to the stage, you think, oh, we're not enjoying this. And then you have the break and then think, right, OK, we've all grown up, we're all older, we'll see this from a different perspective, let's get back together and this time let's have a laugh.
Yeah, I mean, that, I'd love that at some point, because they being with them, it changed my life. It was the best times of my life during it, some of the worst as well, but in the main, it was an amazing experience, and I'd love to do something with them again, 100%.
Mm. Well, lots of people
lovely
would,
to see you.
Like, yeah, and the single...
Welcome home.
Yeah, welcome back.
Oh, thanks very much.
And the single's out now, isn't it?
Yeah,
it is. Better on Me, out now. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Lovely to see you. Thank you very much.